In today's video, we're talking about the Siloam Justice Court. The Siloam Justice Court is a misdemeanor court. It's here in Arizona. It's in La Paz County. We see a lot of people charged with crimes out of this particular court. So today, we're going to tell you a little bit more about it. We'll tell you more about the court's jurisdiction. We'll tell you a little bit more about the prosecutors who are in charge of representing the government and the police in these types of criminal cases. We'll tell you a little bit more about the judge herself. So let's dive into it. When we're talking about the court's jurisdiction, we're talking about the geographic area over which this court has control. It's important to understand what this looks like because if you got cited for a crime and it happened outside of that geographic area, the court doesn't have any power to hear your case and the case should be dismissed. So let's look at Siloam's jurisdiction. And it's not too difficult to see here that it's pretty rectangular. And what we're looking for here is the outline, the border, the geographic area is highlighted there in black, and then the freeways that run through this court are highlighted there in purple. And you can see from our notations there that the major freeway that runs through Siloam is the I-10. The I-10, the Interstate 10, is a major freeway. If you are driving from Central Phoenix or really anywhere in the valley out to California or from California into Phoenix, you are going to pass through the Siloam Justice Court's jurisdiction. A lot of people are passing on the I-10. This area is patrolled predominantly by the Department of Public Safety. Every now and then you'll see the La Paz County Sheriff's officers also on this stretch of roadway, but predominantly you're going to see this patrolled by DPS officers, the Department of Public Safety here in Arizona. And so we see a lot of crimes that are related to traffic offenses. Things like criminal speeding, reckless driving. We do see DUIs come out of this area because people will be kind of enjoying themselves, or we'll see consuming alcohol in a vehicle, those different types of crimes when people are traveling back and forth between Arizona and California. We also see commercial trucking violations. They're called CDL violations for using a cell phone or something like that as the commercial drivers are passing through the I-10 there. If you are stopped or cited or arrested for one of those crimes, what happens next? Well, it's going to get turned over to the La Paz County Attorney's Office. La Paz County attorneys are the prosecutors who are in charge of representing the government. They're prosecuting the crimes. Sometimes people think that if they're stopped by a police officer, that it's up to the officer to decide whether or not they can drop the charges, or that the officer, him or herself, is going to be in charge of prosecuting the case. In reality, the officer as a witness turns the case over to the prosecutor, who then is in charge of moving the case forward. So they're representing the government. They're representing the state against you or somebody you know or love if you're watching this video for somebody else. The La Paz County Attorney's Office, it's a bigger county in Arizona. They tend to operate more on a policy basis, meaning they set certain policies. If your case is over or outside of the policy, they'll give you one plea deal. Otherwise, if it's within their policy to give you a deviation, to give you a better deal, they'll do that. We don't mind working with La Paz County Attorney's Office. We actually think that relative to some of the other prosecuting agencies throughout Arizona, there are some people there who we can work with who are a little bit more open to some of our resolutions that we propose. So it's not a bad place to get cited if you're going to have to be dealing with the La Paz County Attorney's Office. You could do worse than them. The judge, however, Judge Karen Slaughter, is somebody who is a little bit more difficult to deal with. We have had many cases in front of her court, and we've got some opinions on how she runs her courtroom. So a couple different things. Number one, she typically tends to punish attorneys in our experience. She'll kind of punish them by making them physically drive out to Siloam Justice Court, even though there's no reason to do that. You can see here the Siloam Justice Court is located within this jurisdiction, but that doesn't mean that we actually have to physically drive there to handle cases that should be simple continuances, or to handle court proceedings that should just be a simple motion to continue. Unfortunately, this judge will require us to drive out there almost for no reason whatsoever. Stuff that could be handled over the phone, or stuff that we could file a written motion on, this judge just tends to not rule on those things because of whatever her rationale is, but she requires attorneys to physically drive out there. Kind of a big waste of everybody's time, but that's just how she runs her courtroom. This judge is not an attorney in Arizona. You don't have to be a justice of the peace judge, which is what she is. All you have to do is run for office and get elected. The other commentary that we have about this judge is that she tends to involve herself a little bit more than we think is appropriate in a lot of cases. So when you're dealing with the judge is supposed to be sort of the neutral fact finder, the arbiter between the prosecution and the defense, and not get too involved in the cases. This judge likes to do that. So we see that this judge will kind of insert herself in the process, really try to hurry the case along or put pressure on the defense in favor of the government to move the case along, even though discovery hasn't been completed, meaning we have not done our full work. We haven't done our interviews, or we haven't requested some of the data that we need, or we're just not ready to move forward. This judge will say, well, got to move the case forward. We got to set it for trial. We got to hurry it along through, even though we haven't done our due diligence. We haven't done our investigation. We haven't done our defense work, which we're entitled to do. You're being charged with a crime out of this court. We are entitled to build our defense and follow the rules. And so we can find that to be a little bit frustrating. Similarly, sometimes this judge likes to insert herself in the negotiation process. So if we're negotiating back and forth between the prosecutor's office and maybe we've reached a resolution, we've made a proposal, we've made a request for a deviation, we think we have a case resolved, we present it to the judge. Judge doesn't like that resolution, so that judge denies that, even though we've all agreed to it. So it can be a little bit frustrating to deal with this court. In Arizona, there's a rule, it's called a notice for a change of judge. Every side gets one as a matter of right. So the prosecutor gets one, the defense gets one. What this rule says is that you're entitled to change that judge. You have to follow the rules. You can't do it for bias purposes. You can't do it in a blanket fashion. There's a lot of rules around it. You have to do it at a certain time and these types of things. But this may not be a bad time to use that rule, to use the rule to file a notice for a change of judge so you get a different judge, somebody who's a little bit more, we would say, favorable in terms of dealing with to reach a good outcome, may want to consider it. You may not. Of course, it's going to depend on a lot of the facts of your case. It's going to depend on what the charges are. It's going to depend on what your background is and all of those different things. So if you were somebody that you know or love has been charged with a crime out of the Siloam Justice Court, give our office a call. We offer free case evaluations. We have a lot of experience out of this court. We'll be able to have you come in. We'll sit down or we'll schedule a telephonic phone call. We'll discuss your case, make sure you understand exactly how it's going to work out of Siloam, but more importantly, make sure you have a plan to make sure that we can help you through this. So give us a call. Free case evaluations, literally nothing to lose. We look forward to speaking with you soon. Thanks for watching.